Hello, Reformers, and welcome to a special feature of Tocan's Calradia, employing the Pure Nord Challenge along the way as well. So, let us get underway, and if you want to know more about the Pure Nord Challenge, or to download the mod, then please check in the description below. So, let's head on, and we will start our character. Of course, we will be male for this, as is dictated by the challenge's rules. And now, let's take a look here. This is going to be quite difficult. I think considering we are going to be Nord, I would like a lot of, well, agility, I suppose, to get some increased athletic skill. So I think we're going to go for Thief. And as the son of a thief, you had very little formal education. Instead, you were out on the street, begging until you learned how to cut purses. Cutting purses until you learned how to pick locks, all the way through your childhood. Still, these long years made you streetwise, and sharp to the secrets of cities and shadowy backways. You started to learn about the world almost as soon as you could walk and talk. You spent your early life as, well, seeing as we were a thief, I think a street urchin is probably going to be the most logical progression from there, so we're gonna pick that. As a boy growing out of childhood, you took to the streets, doing whatever you must to survive, begging, thieving, and working for gangs to earn your bread. You lived from day to day in this violent world, always one step ahead of the law and those who wished you ill. Then, as a young adult, life changed as it always does. You became, well, I think it would be quite nice if we became something a little more respectable, and I'm thinking maybe a goods peddler or a smith, perhaps? Because that is rather middle way. I think a smith might be quite nice. Though the distinction felt sudden to you, somewhere along the way you had become a man, and the whole world seemed to change around you. You pursued a career as a smith, crafting items of function and beauty out of simple metal. As time wore on, you became a master of your trade, and fine work started to fetch fine prices. With food in your belly and logs on your fire, you could take pride in your work and your growing reputation. But soon everything changed, and you decided to strike out on your own as an adventurer. And we're going to go for personal revenge, of course. So, there we are. Very nice indeed. We will allow us to quit without saving, of course. Yes, thank you very much. And, ooh, we actually start with some very nice strength and agility right here. I think that is going to help us out quite a bit in the early game and progress through to having a very high strength skill indeed. Let's hope, anyway. So, I think what we're going to go for first is, I think we're probably just going to go for 11-11 so that next time we get two levels, we can just advance those to 12-12 almost immediately. I think that's probably going to be the best bet at the moment. And now, concerning the Nord challenge, I believe what we require is power throw and two-handed proficiency, of course, because what we're going to be using is two sets of throwing axes, a shield, and a two-handed axe, so as to convey the Nord in us, oh yes. And of course, we are going to only be using Nord-themed armor, and we are not going to be using a horse either, so this is going to be a complete infantry episode, yes. So, here we go. I think we're going to go for some power throw so we can use those early on, and power strike, of course. And I think, considering we're probably going to be in the fray quite a bit, I would like some HP. So let's get to 50 HP. I suppose that will help us out quite a bit. And of course, let's get some two-handed weaponry. There we are. Okay, so for a name, this is actually very difficult. I scoured the internets for a rather good name, and I suppose for a special feature, this will actually suit us quite well, so let's actually type properly, shall we? Yes, there we are. Heimdall, I think that will suit us quite well. So, let us head on, and we will select his face. Now, I must mention, Tocan's face generation is actually incredibly good, as you can see. The default face is actually very good compared to the default, without any mods, of course. So, yes, what I will be doing is checking out these faces, and when I have found one of suitable beard length, then I will cut back. Okay, so I think we have found our Heimdall. Now, you may notice that the age slider is rather extravagant, and that is for a very good reason, considering Heimdall is very old indeed, so we will be going for him as that, and I think considering we are in Nordic territory, we will be going for some blonde hair, so yes, let's go with that. And now, as the challenge dictates, we will be starting in Sargoth. Oh yes. Okay, so, oh wow, okay, we're here already. Very nice indeed, and I think, to be honest, what we want to do first is actually just head in to the marketplace, because from what I can see here, we only have a tunic with vest and some ragged leather boots. So it would be quite nice if we could actually, oh my, I would love to be able to use this. As you can see, it is a two-handed. Cannot use a shield with it, of course. And you can also use it as a polearm. But I actually want to use this instead, because look at it. Absolutely amazing. I think we'll probably go for... Oh, actually, never mind. I don't have any money. That's actually something to take into account here, isn't it? Yes, okay. Maybe instead of that, we will be going for a shield. I think we'll go for this. It is a Nordic design, so I think that will help us out quite a bit. And it's a bargain as well. Only 92 dinars. Now, let's just check out, see if we can get any pieces of armor that might help us out. Oh my. Okay, this might be a little tricky. Okay, I think, considering I saw this here, we're probably going to take this. And... well, yeah, that's actually not better, is it? I was about to say, let's take that. It looks like a blacksmith's apron. Yeah. Okay. I think that will actually be fine for now. We have a shield. I think that's pretty much all I really wanted. Okay, so I think now what we will want to do is, of course, the Nord challenge does call for us to use axes, two-handed axes, and throwing axes. We don't actually have access to those just yet. So I think, actually, we could just head back to Sargoth really quick, and we could actually buy this axe here. It's a heavy hand axe. Now, of course, it doesn't look too Nordic at the moment, which is a little unfortunate. I think I won't be using those knives either. I think we'll go straight Nord at the moment until we get some throwing axes. That would be quite nice. So let's try to avoid these sea raiders for now. I do want to fight them a little bit later on, though. And yes, pilfer their gear as best we can, because they have some very nice pieces of armor. Okay, be careful. We do not want to be next to these fellows, that is for sure. Okay, let's go down and maybe make our way here. Okay, they're not pursuing us, which is very nice indeed of them. Okay. Let's head to Yelbeggy, I think. Yes. Okay, so yes, now the choice of mod in this particular instance is mainly due to the fact I thought, well, it has the standard troop trees, and it seems to me like an improved version of native Warband. So I thought to myself, that's a rather nice amount of nostalgia right there. So I thought, well, we may as well do a special feature on it and see whether you guys like it. So yes, please let me know in the comments, by the way, whether you do. And yes, we will hopefully get some rather good entertainment out of this right here. So there we are, more Nord recruits, not bad. And we will just continue onward. Now, hopefully, what I will be able to find is a Sea Raider party of, well, let's just say, less substantial amounts of units. As you can see there. Okay, looters. Ah, we might be able to take those on after we visit Rizzy. So, yes, there we are. That is actually not too bad. Now, Nord recruits, they aren't exactly the greatest, of course, but they are actually higher level than me, so I think they're probably going to be quite good in a fight, so I think we're probably going to take these guys on. They are 14, though. Yeah. Okay. I have faith in my Nords. We can do this. Okay. Let's go. Okay, so we have 12, they have 14. We have all Nords. Now, according to the challenge, of course, there are no horses, so we will be playing complete infantry right here. So let's get ready to charge them, and I'm just hoping that they actually drop something useful. Okay, so they're very... okay, yes. We are as well quite disorganized, as you can see, and there's the Wilhelm scream. Yes, did I forget to mention that there's actually a sound effect of Wilhelm in this mod? Very amusing indeed. And it would actually be good if I could actually hit someone. That might be nice. Maybe I can get some XP from that fellow. Never mind. This is going to be a very amusing special feature, no doubt, as you can probably tell. Me missing every single strike in existence. But there we are. We do actually gain a couple of Nord footmen, which is great. They are on their way to Nord trained footmen, and I have 700 dinars now. Yeah, so as you can see here, these are all going to be discounted. I will not be using any of these, although I think it probably will be okay if I use nomad armor for now, or maybe a rawhide coat, but it's worse in every respect. Now, I am trying to keep to the Nord theme, of course, but this early on, it's actually pretty tricky to be able to do that, so I hope you will forgive me for this small infraction. But yes, once we have fully garnered and pilfered every single item from a sea raider party, then I'm hoping we'll be able to look a little more Nordish, which would be quite nice. So yes, let's just continue to get those. Oh my, okay, yes. As you can see, there are actually named units in this, similar to, I suppose, Blood and Steel, and perhaps Light and Darkness as well. Yeah, so yeah, that's going to be a rather substantial enemy in the future. Now, talking of enemies, there are actually forces of darkness in this particular mod, and they happen to be accessible through here, I believe. Yes, there we are. Set when the Dark Knight's invasion begins. So this is obviously very early in development, this particular feature, of course, as if we select it, as you can see here, are the Dark Knights allowed to invade? This feature is in early development and not really tested. If you are playing on a good save, please make a copy before you let them invade, just in case something goes wrong. But as you can see here, we can click Never Let Them Invade, we can get them to invade immediately, or we can select an unknown date in the future. So, potentially, what we will be doing is selecting an unknown date in the future, and if they do not spawn while I am actually recording this special feature, then I will be selecting immediately, and we will potentially engage them in battle. So let's select unknown date for now. There we are. And then we will see whether they decide to invade at some point. So let's just take a look here. I don't think anything else really is that needed at the moment. So yeah, we're just going to leave everything else the way it is, and we will be heading into Brilin to get some more recruits. Oh yes, nice. We got 4 there, and I suppose we'll just head on and hope for some sea raiders along the way, maybe. That would be quite advantageous. Let's do it. Aha, there we are. Ooh, 5. Wow, that's actually quite a lot, considering we don't have any relation with these villages just yet. We have 20 soldiers now, so I think we might actually be able to take on the larger groups of sea raiders. We do actually have a maximum party capacity of 41, which is, yeah, actually unheard of for me, but yes, we will hopefully be able to max that out and engage some sea raiders. Now, there is the huge party over there, as you can see. They are following us, but don't think we really need to worry about them just yet. They are moving a little slower than us. Now, what I am actually going to be doing is unequipping the saddle horse, because, yeah, I think it would be a little bit frustrating. Oh my, they're actually in tier. But yes, as I was saying, a little bit frustrating to get off our horse every single battle, so I'm just going to be running around like a poor old man. yes. I suppose if you like the visual effect of the horse, then you can actually ride it and then just get off at the beginning of the fight, but I think it adds more authenticity to run around like this. So, yeah, let's just go to Sargoth, considering those bandits are all around tier. I was hoping I would be able to sell over there, but no such luck. So let's just continue onward. Yes, there we are. I think we can make it in there very easily indeed. So I would like to sell items automatically, technically, so let's hope that we can actually do that. Yes, we can. Great. Okay, and a couple of other things here, and I think we're probably just going to sell them manually. So, yeah, that will be fine, I think. Yeah, and whoa, this guy is really rich. As you can see, 19,000. Oh my goodness. We are hopefully going to be taking his money rather shortly. Now, there is yet another feature of this mod that I am very anxious to talk about, and that is the wide variety of companions that you can potentially find. Now, Oh yeah, it's actually not helping me at all at the moment. As you can probably tell, there are no companions in the tavern here, which is very unfortunate. But according to a trusted source, I've been told that there are over 97 companions in the mod itself. So yeah, you can imagine the amount of choice you can get. So yes, we're probably and hopefully going to be encountering some of those along the way. And yeah, we'll be able to see their backstories if they have some, and their skills, of course. We're probably going to see some very powerful ones as well. So I think, considering I've talked for a substantial amount of time now, I will be cutting away once again and hopefully being able to find a Sea Raider party. So I will see you soon. Okay, so as you can see, we are currently in sight of some Sea Raiders, and they actually are very substantial in power. As you can see, they have Sea Raider Leader and a veteran Sea Raider as well, 11 Sea Raiders among them. So we will be hopefully pursuing and engaging them, and it seems as though they were perfectly happy to attack us here, which is not very pleasing to say the least. So I think we're probably going to attempt to stay around here, because I don't really want to head towards that hill, because I can slightly imagine that they're going to have the upper ground, and I would like to fight on an even keel right here, just in case. You never know. And we will hopefully be able to pull this off. Now, we do have some Nord footmen, which is great, so they're gonna hopefully be able to tank some of the hits from their throwing weapons. If they indeed do have throwing weapons, well, what am I saying? They are Sea Raiders, they will definitely have throwing weapons. Maybe even archers. Who knows? So let's actually get ready right here. As soon as they hit the bottom of the valley, we will be charging at them head first. We are Nords, after all. Oh, yes. Okay, so we are ready. Come on, fellows, let us get ready. And we will now charge in. Let's do it. Go, guys. We do actually have some throwing axes as well. Some of our people have throwing axes. Let's get in there and not do much. There we are. Do some nice damage right there. Okay, now, I do not really want to rush those veterans, that's for sure, but I would like to help our fellows actually defeat the ones we are currently fighting. Now, this guy is actually very well armored, as you can see. Sea Raider. Wow, that's actually just a regular Sea Raider. Okay. Well, I was hoping that I would be able to find someone a little more powerful to defeat, but it seems this guy might actually be one. Oh, nope, never mind. He is a regular Sea Raider as well, and I think we might actually be defeated in this case. Well, that's unfortunate, isn't it? Huh. Well, I suppose he does have a two-handed axe, and that's rather substantial, I must admit. Oh my. Okay, well, 31 Nord recruits were not enough to take out some Sea Raiders, although we did take out Sea Raider Leader and Veteran Sea Raider, so that's actually not too bad. We do lose a couple of dinars and some tools, but I don't think that will really put us off too much. Now, unfortunately, yeah, they only had 7 remaining. Wait a minute, that's not them, is it? I actually have no idea which party defeated us right there. But yes, anyway, it seems that was a little ill-advised. I probably should have headed to Swadian territory and taken on some looters, perhaps. Yes, that probably would have been a better idea. So if I indeed do a series on this mod, if you are requesting it, then I will probably head that way instead. But I think for now, what we will do is, considering we have seen a little of the progression that we would have in a regular series of this mod, I think what I will do now is enhance our progression, and we will enact the invasion of the Dark Knights. So I will see you very shortly. Okay, so I think before we unleash the Dark Knights upon the world, we will be checking out the other particular features that the mod has to offer, and one of them is actually this salt mine right here. And yes, we don't actually have the greatest history with salt mines, I must admit. There was actually one in Britain Water, I believe, and I did not really do very well there, yes. Apparently the formula for salt mine management is to have two guards for every one prisoner. But in my, yes, ultimate wisdom, I placed 30 prisoners and 3 guards. So yes, not exactly the greatest, but yeah, here we are. We can actually head in and talk to the NPC here. Aha! I want to buy some salt. Don't really want to do that, at the moment anyway. And we do actually have some prisoners. Aha! Well, we don't actually have any prisoners yet, but you can get some prisoners here. I'm always looking for new slaves because nobody wants to work in the mines. You earn 10 dinars weekly per slave. I think in the future you think twice if you sell your prisoners. Bring them to me. Aha, so there we are. We actually have a rather large prisoner hold here of 40. Yeah. But yes, there was a small sneak peek at my new army as well, by the way. As you can see here, we have 46 Nord Huskarls and 28 Veteran Archers. Now, I do realize that the Nord Huskarl count is a little extravagant, but I don't think you will be too displeased for too long, considering the Dark Knights are going to be coming out any moment. So, what we will be doing is heading to Uxcarl, I believe, and we will then unleash the Dark Knights, and we will see what they are able to do within a short space of time. I have a feeling that they are going to be able to capture things very fast indeed. So, let's head into the preferences here and immediately set them to invade. The Dark Knights will shortly begin their invasion. Oh yes, okay, so we will be waiting here for some time, and a frightened and exhausted messenger boy rides up to you, his face red and hair soaked with sweat. "My lord," he cries, running up to you. "Wait, you must hear me out." After catching his breath, the messenger hands you a slip of paper. "War has come. Conquerors from another land have stepped on Calradian ground, bent on domination. Escape, my lord, while you still can. I have seen them myself, their armor as black as night, their eyes cold as steel." With that, the boy rides off, shouting to any who will listen. There we are. And we are currently waiting for some time, so we will see where the Dark Knights want to strike first. Now, I think we're probably going to be having a few issues with morale soon, so it would be quite nice if we could fight something to prevent us from losing any troops. So let's hope that the Dark Knights show themselves and decide where they are going to be. Ah, oh no, that's a Hun castle. Yes, where they are going to be sieging, I was going to say. And wow, I'm actually really surprised that they haven't taken anything yet, because they seem very powerful indeed. Oh my goodness! How dare you, Swadia! Look at that! The Dark Knights in the Kingdom of Swadia have concluded a non-aggression treaty. How could you? Well, that is rather impressive. And oh my goodness, we actually receive an offer of vassalage, as you can see here. Queen Catalus of Praven of the Kingdom of Swadia has sent a royal herald to bring you an invitation in her own hand. You would be granted the honor of becoming a vassal lord of the Kingdom of Swadia, and in return, Queen Catalus of Praven asks you to swear an oath of homage to her and fight in her military campaigns, offering you the fief of Yalib for your royal service. She will surely be offended if you do not take the offer. Well, considering this is a pure Nord challenge, I am technically not allowed to join the Swadians, so we will be declining. Unfortunately. Otherwise, yes, if King Ragnar, if he still is King Ragnar, I'm not entirely sure who is leading the Nords in this particular variation of the game, then I probably would have accepted, no problem at all. But yes, it seems as though I will be safe in Uxcarl for now then, considering the Dark Knights have made a non-aggression treaty with them. So yeah. Oh, it seems everyone is actually going to be offering us vassalage, which is going to be very nice. I did increase my renown a little bit just to make sure that we would actually get a couple of offers perhaps, which is what is actually happening now, so it's great. Of course, this is from the Rodox, so we will be declining once again. Let's just hope that we actually get the Nord soon. That would be a definite plus. And I'm actually wondering where the Dark Knights are going to attack first. Okay, so the Sarenids and the Vagiers have concluded a non-aggression treaty, and I think I'm probably going to be cutting away here, because I assumed... Ah, there we are, Kudan has been besieged by Lord Purin of the Dark Knights. So, we will be quitting waiting there, and we will be heading to Kudan, which is all the way over there. Oh my, they actually travelled quite a far distance. Okay, so, yeah, it doesn't actually help that I have very low pathfinding, does it? Yes, moving very slowly indeed. Well, let's just hope that we don't come across anyone too unsavory just yet. I would like to test out our newly found army, of course. And who's that? Oh, deserters. That's not too bad. Okay, so, let us head over there and be very wary of any Dark Knight parties, that is for sure. They are quite powerful from what I have heard. So, let's get over here. Come on. Let's get over there, Heimdall. We have to do it. Oh, oh my goodness. As you can see, there is actually a siege going on, as you can tell, by the spikes all around it. That is very nice indeed. Very nice visual effect. And we will be, I suppose, maybe heading in. I don't know. Oh, no, we will not be heading in. As you can see, they have actually gone into Kudan with every single vassal under their command. So we will be waiting outside here until they are done, for now at least. And we will see how it goes. I advise the bandits to actually move away from that area. It is soon going to be swarming with the Dark Knight hordes. So let's be a little cautious here ourselves as well, because you never know, the bandits might see fit to actually attack us. That would be terrible. And it seems as though one of the Khergit Khanate has been taken prisoner by the Dark Knights as well. Okay, so they're still under siege. This is rather rare, I must admit. I assume they are going to be rather fast. Oh my goodness, this guy is actually coming after us. He does have 200 in his army, so I see why. That is a little unfortunate. Oh, I'm hoping it will just be done soon so we can take a look at the Dark Knights. That would be so cool. Oh no. Okay, wait a minute. Ooh, careful. We want to be very cautious of the bandits, that is for sure. Okay, so we do have some Tundra bandits here. We could actually try our luck, shall we say, against these bandits, but I think they are just about to capture Kudan. So let's be ready for that. Very soon, very soon. There we go, okay. As you can see, all the Vagiers were managing to escape right there. And as, whoa, okay. That is rather immense, isn't it? Okay. Well, I'm actually hoping that one of them will split off and attempt to fight us, but it does not seem that is going to be the case at the moment. So I think what I will do is cut away for now, and when I see fit to engage one of these fellows, which is probably going to be quite some time, I think they're probably going to target Rivercheg next. So once they have taken that, maybe they will then split off from the pack. Of course, there is their queen to attack, which is probably not the best idea, considering she does have over 500 in her army. So I will be cutting away for now, and once I have engaged one of their vassals in combat, I will cut back. Okay, so we are lucky enough to be able to intercept a couple of Dark Knight vassals on their way to siege Raverdin. As you can see, they have actually ravaged the Vagir kingdom rather considerably, yes. I'm a little bit intimidated, as you can tell, but they've only done it in a couple of days, as you can see. I think we left off at around April 15th, maybe April 16th, and it's only a week later and they've taken all of that, so they are very fast movers indeed. Now, we do have a vassal with 66 and 43 units. Of course, you do see the Dark Knight commanders right there. I'm a little bit intimidated by those. So, yes, we might indeed see a defeat, but I do not worry about that, as it is showing you guys what this is all about. Now, of course, I did actually find a companion. I did actually neglect to mention this the last time around. And he has, Well, let's just say he has some pretty good skills. As you can see, he has 18 in strength, and I did increase his intelligence a little bit so that we could get some pathfinding and a little bit of surgery just to help us out. So there we are. I think we will be heading in. Oh, that is exactly not what I wanted to happen. There are even more than we actually wanted. Oh, yeah, as you can see, there we go. 76 against 327. That is exactly what I didn't want to happen, but we will be heading in anyway. As you can see, I do actually have some pretty good armor on to further consolidate our status as a Nord. And we do have a rather large two-handed axe and some throwing axes as well. So let's get into a pretty good formation here. I do actually have some archers, so it would be quite nice if we could set those up into a good vantage point. I don't really think it will make much difference, but it would be rather nice to get us into a good place here and maybe take a few of them out. It would be quite good. So let's get our guys up here. They do all have shields, which is good. And we will then be able to hopefully take a few out, because they are very intimidating, as you can tell, by all of their horses in formation. This is going to be rather tricky, considering I only have a couple of archers as well to poke away at them. And they have 170 on the battlefield, so I am pretty sure this is going to be somewhat difficult to achieve victory right here. But I do have a companion, so hopefully if we are defeated, we might be able to avoid complete defeat. So let's hope that we can actually do this. Let's go. Let's just charge in. Let's do it. Come on, guys. I'm ready. Let's change to our one-handed axe. And oh, a couple of our guys are actually fleeing because we are in such grave circumstances right here. Oh no, this is not good. Oh, this is a shield basher technique. Nice, cool. I like that. Okay, let's come on, take this guy down. Come on, we can take one down, can't we? No, apparently not. Oh no. Yeah, as you can see, they do completely destroy. Oh, we actually took someone out. That is amazing. Okay, so we did actually take someone out, which is rather extraordinary, considering we are completely outnumbered, mainly due to my poor decision-making on when to engage right there. But yeah, I think we were somewhat expecting ourselves to be defeated by these Dark Knights. It shows how incredibly powerful they are, as you can see, as they all stream towards the last couple of our units. And I think we will actually be retreating before we lose any more of our units. And there we are, we can actually leave and hopefully run away. Yes, there we go. Okay, so we took a look at some of the Dark Knight units, and we will hopefully be able to take them on at a later time, if indeed there is a series, who knows. But there is actually one thing that I wanted to do before we end this off, and that is to head out to sea and actually take part in a naval battle. So I am going to cut away, and when I have found some sea raiders or whoever is actually on the sea at this time, I will cut back. Okay, so we are lucky enough to have found some sea raiders on the ocean waves, and we will now be encountering them. As you can see, 33 of our troops against 51 of theirs. Close in and board the enemy. Oh yes, okay, this is the first time I've actually done one of these. Okay, so, here we go. Come on, let's do it. Take him down. I have a two-handed axe, and it's very extravagant indeed. Careful. We are Nords, after all, but we do not want to actually get taken down, shall we? Oh my goodness, they're actually falling off the edge here and everything. There we are, take out that Sea Raider leader, and I think we're probably going to be okay. I hope so, at least. Seems as though we might do quite well. I would like to be able to use my throwing axes, though, a little bit more. Yes. Okay. Well, it's actually not too bad. We're doing quite well. I don't think I should expect any less, though, considering we do have a rather large amount of huskarls. Come on. Oh, yeah, there we are. And that is the last Sea Raider up there on the other ship. And maybe we can actually snipe him with my amazing throwing skills. Nope, something tells me no. Okay, well, there we are. That was a naval battle. Very quick indeed. A little bit unfortunate it was so fast, but there we are anyway. We do actually gain some renown and morale in the process too, which is not bad at all. And we are now able to loot quite a few items here. And there we are. That is it. Great. So there we are. That is the end of Tocan's Calradia, special feature, pure Nord edition. And I hope you enjoyed it. I certainly did, well, apart from being defeated by the Dark Knights, of course. And yeah, I thank you for watching. I will see you next time.